between the numerator and the denominator. Okay, so how can I write the denominator? I can write the denominator as cot of 90 minus 36. When I am subtracting 90 out of your 36, the resultant is your 54. Okay. So now I am taking the other value. So when I have taken here the value of theta, the resultant is your tan theta. So similarly, I can write this one as tan 36 by tan 36. Okay. So this comes out to be, this divides out equally. Okay. So the overall resultant is 1 only. So let's look at the next sum similarly. So what is the relationship you need to be using here? I will be using sine 90 minus theta equal to cos theta. Okay. So let us see how do I implement this one over here. I am writing cos 12 minus sine of 90 minus 12. Okay. When I am subtracting 90 out of 12, when I am subtracting 12 out of 90, when I am subtracting 12 out of 90, the resultant is your, the resultant is your sine 78. Okay. So I am taking this number now. So this becomes as cos 12 minus your cos 12. So the overall value is 0. Let's look at the next one. See, what is the relationship I need to use here? I need to use secant of 90 minus theta equal to your cosecant of theta. Okay, so that how can I write this? I can write this as cosec 31 degrees minus secant of 90 minus 31. Okay, so overall resultant of this one comes out to be cosecant 31 minus cosecant 31 only, because I am taking this value. So the resultant of this becomes nothing but 0. 90 minus theta equivalent to your cosecant of theta. Okay. So when I am using this identity, how to rewrite this one? I can write this as sine 15 into secant of 90 minus 75 degrees directly. Okay. So the resultant of this one comes out to be your sine 15 into cosec 15. Cosec 15. What is the relationship between cosec and the sine? Is cosec and theta can be written as 1 by sine theta. So I can write this as sine 15 degrees is nothing but 1 by your sine 15 degrees. So this one is removed out. So the overall answer is left out only 1. Let's look at the fifth one over here. See, what is the relationship? How can I write this tan degree? See, I can write tan of, I can write tan of 90 minus theta equivalent to your cot theta, isn't it? So using this identity, I can write it. And what is the relationship between these two? That is your tan and cot. This is the relationship. Okay. So now looking at this equation over here, so I can rewrite this one as this values over here, trigonometric values over here. I can write tan 26 into tan of 90 minus 26, isn't it? I am taking the other value directly, so that I can write here tan 26 into cot 26. I can write the cot value as 1 by tan value, so that this and this is removed out, cancelled out, and 1 is left out. Let's look at the next one. You need to show that LHS is equal to your RHS. So let me consider only the value of LHS. Okay, I'm taking only the value of LHS as of now, that is tan 48. Tan 16, tan 42, tan 74. Okay. So how do I write this? What are the identities I need to use here? I will be using the identities as n of 90 minus theta equal to cot theta. This identity I can write in this identities as usually. Okay. Also the relationship what I'll be using here is cot theta equivalent to 1 by n theta. These are the identities I will be using over here. So if you look at these numbers, so that is tan 48 into tan 16. See, this number, this identity, this trigonometric ratio can be written as like this. And this trigonometric ratio, this trigonometric value, not ratio, this trigonometric value can be written like this. Okay. Now I am taking this value, now I am taking this value, so that this shifts out to be cot 16 and this also shifts out to be cot 48 and I am left with only tan 16 into tan 48 into tan 48. Now I can also write the values of, that is the values of cot value as like this. So here I can write this cot value as tan of 48. Here also I can write it as cot of 16. So let's see how do I do this. This one and this. Okay, tan 16 and tan 16 is removed out. Tan 48 and this is also removed out. So I left out only with 1 as my answer. I hope I am clear up to here, no doubts whatsoever, right? So let's see what can be done the earlier thing. So let us look at the next sum. 6 degrees cos 54, the LHS is given as cos 36 degrees cos 54 degrees minus sin 36 degrees into sin 54 degrees. Okay, so how, what are the identities I am using here? I will use here cos 90 minus theta equal to sin theta. Okay, so let's see how do I write this. I can write this as cos of 90 degrees minus 54 degrees into cos of 90 degrees minus 36 degrees minus sin 36 minus sin 36 sin 54 degrees. Okay, and taking the other values here, so that this comes out as to be sine of 54 degrees into sine 36 degrees minus sine 36 degrees into sine 54 degrees. So if you see this one and this is removed out, even 36 and 36 is also removed out. So this is equivalent to your 0, that is your RHS. So I can write this one as LHS is equivalent to your RHS at last. Hope this is also clear. So let's look at the next one. So this is your given option. So let us see what is given over here. Given over here is tan 2A equal to cot of A minus 18 degrees. Okay. A minus 18 degrees. So how do I write this? The identity what I will use here is I will use tan theta equals to cot of 90 minus theta. Hope this is clear to everyone. Okay. So I can rewrite this term as cot of 90 minus 2a, isn't it? Equal to cot of A minus 18 degrees directly. This and this is cancelled out as it is equated. Now I am left out with 90 minus 2A equal to A minus 18, isn't it? Now I am shifting the number the other side. What will it become? 90 plus 18 minus 2A equivalent to your A value. Now when I am adding up these two, this is 108 equal to, I'm shifting this number, the alphabet to the other side. I have left with A plus 2A, isn't it? So 108 is equivalent to 3a. So what would be the value of A? He is asking us to remove the value of A only, right? So I can rewrite this one as A is equivalent to 108 by 3. When you are dividing this, what would be the value of this one? 108, you need to divide this using 3, right? So 3 threes are, you are having what, 9? I'm subtracting this, 1 is left out, 8 is left out, 3 6 are is your 18. So hope this is also clear. So A is equals to your 36 degrees only. So A equal to your 36 degrees only, right? Good. So let me write this properly. So A equal to your 36 degrees only. Okay. So this is the required value of A. So this will be the required value of A. So let's look at the next one. Given that, what is the information given over here? You need to write the given information as usual always. Tan A is equal to your cot B. We know the identity that tan theta can be written as cot of 90 minus theta, right? So I'm substituting it over here. So this can be written as cot of 90 minus A equal to cot of B, isn't it? So this one is left out. So I am left out with only 90 degrees minus A equal to B. I am shifting this A to the other side. So we are left with 90 is equal to A plus B. So what is the value? This is what is required to prove. Hence it is proved. I hope I am clear up to here. Let's look at the next sum. So that he says that these are the interior angles of a triangle. As you all know, interiors of a triangle, if it is the interior of the triangle, sum of all the angles of a triangle is how much? Sum of the angles in the triangle, even if it's interior, it is nothing but the summation of all the angles in a triangle is 180 degrees, right? It's a rule. Now, what I will do is, I will divide this by your number 2 so that the resultant becomes A plus B plus C by 2 equal to 180 by 2 here, right? I can also write this term as A plus B by 2 plus C by 2 equal to 90. Isn't it? Now, I am shifting the only C to the other side, that is A plus B by 2 equal to 90 minus C of 2. Am I clear up to here? Now, what we will do here is, I am applying and on both the sides, okay? Applying and on both the sides. So, when I do this, what would be the resultant? The resultant over here is tan of A plus B by 2 equal to tan of 90 minus C by 2, and taking only the value of C, so that the overall resultant turns out to be 2 by 2, A plus B by 2 equals to cot of C by 2, which is required to prove, hence it is proved. Let's look at the next value here. See, you need to express these numbers in terms of these ratios of the angles. Okay, let's see how do I do this. See, if you are having this value, how to make this one as 90? I need to make this one as 90 so that I can write it as sin 90 minus 15, isn't it? Plus, similarly, how can I write the other one? I can write it as cos 90 minus 25, right? So, as you all know that sin of 90 minus theta is always equivalent to your cos theta. So this can be written as cos 15 degrees plus, similarly, how to write this one here, cos of 90 minus theta equals is equal to your sin theta. So here we'll get sine 25 degrees. Okay. I hope this is clear. Now we have written the angles in between. See the values over here. These are between 0 to 45 degrees only. Hope this is also clear to everyone. Right?